Hi, I'm Tina.
Hi, I'm Kenny.
And this is one of our weekly book club sessions.
Yay!
Yay! So today we'll be discussing Huckleberry Finn. So, how much have you read since last week?
Oh, I was very busy. I didn't really read.
Did you at least get
to kill me.
Did you at least get a few chapters down?
Yeah, probably up to chapter 6.
Not too bad. Okay, let's talk about gender and queer theory, because that was pretty prominent in these chapters.
Okay.
Okay, so gender studies and queer theory explore issues of sexuality, power, and marginalized populations, women as other, in literature and culture. Much of the work is gender studies and queer theory, while influenced by feminist criticism, emerges from post-structural interest in fragmented, decentered knowledge building, language, and psychoanalysis. A primary concern in gender studies and queer theory is the manner in which gender and sexuality is discussed. Effective as this work, feminism was in changing what teachers taught and what the students read. There was a sense on the part of some feminist critics that it was still the old game that was being played, when what needed was a new game entirely. The argument posed was that in order to counter patriarchy, it was necessary not merely to think about new texts, but to think about them in radically new ways. Therefore, a critic working in gender studies and queer theory might even be uncomfortable with the binary established by many feminist scholars between masculine and feminine. Each pair can be analyzed as a hierarchy in which the former term represents the positive, the masculine, and the latter, the negative and feminine principle.
Thank you, Tina, for your information. I learned a lot from that. So let me explain what queer theory is. Queer theory is a field of critical theory that emerged in the 1990s out of the fields of LGBT sources and feminist studies. It is kind of interpretation devoted to queer readings of texts. Heavily influenced by the work of Jacob Edwards, queer theory builds upon feminist challenges to the idea that gender is part of the essential self and upon gay, lesbian studies. Close examination of the socially constructed nature of sexual acts and identities. It concentrates on mismatches between sex, gender, and desire. Queer has been associated most prominently with bisexual, lesbian, and gay subjects. But analytic framework also includes such topics as cross-dressing, intersex, gender ambiguity, and gender corrective surgery. So that's it. Do you have any questions?
So you're telling me.
Yes.
Queer theory and homosexuality are basically the same thing, right?
No. I'm not. So let's see.
Then what's the difference?
The difference between the gay theory and the lesbian theory and queer theory is that gay and lesbian studies focuses on its inquiries into natural and unnatural behavior with respect to homosexual behavior, and queer theory expands its focus to encompass any kind of sexual activity or identity that falls into normative or deviant categories. So basically, gay theory examines sexual difference as it's applicable to the male gender, and lesbian theory examines sexual difference as it's applicable to the female gender, and queer theory attempts to examine sexual difference separate from gender altogether, or with radical deprivileging of the status of gender in traditional discourses.
Oh, silly me, how'd I mess that up?
Let's now relate queer theory and gender studies to Huckleberry Finn.
How does that even relate?
Okay, well, let's see. You remember the time when Huckleberry Finn, he goes to a house on shore to ask the woman about Jim and Huckleberry Finn himself,
and then he disguises himself as a girl. So he, you know, they have a little, you know, girly talk, and then the woman, she discovers that Huckleberry Finn is not a girl, because at first he introduces herself as Sarah Lawrence, and then later on the woman was being very suspicious, so she asks Huck Finn, what is your name again? And then he gives out this other name other than Sarah Lawrence, and then, you know, he was being very fidgety and he couldn't properly thread a needle. Remember that part?
Oh, so basically he didn't like exhibit female traits, right?
Yes.
Got it. Oh, what about that other time too? Remember when they first like got to the river and they saw a dead body floating in the river?
Yeah.
And they thought it was a man at first because they were wearing male clothes. But then afterwards, Huck realizes it's a female because of the way body was floating.
Yeah, the body was facing down. Yeah.
So I guess this just shows that opposite sexes have different roles and expectations.
Mm-hmm.
Which relates to gender studies and queer theory.
Yes.
So I guess guys and girls just have different traits. Guys just can't pull off being a girl.
Wait, so are you saying that every guy out there in the world can't pull it off?
Yes, especially you.
Okay, how much you want to bet that I can? Like, Huck Finn was just being dumb.
All right, show me.
He's so unnatural.
Show me.
I'll show you.
I got one question.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey! Hi!
Okay.
Oh.
Here, hit the controller. Okay, ready?
Alright, let's play.
Alright, ready?
Wait, is that guy dying?
Yeah.
Why is he dying?
I'm shooting at
him. No, it's too much blood. Stop! 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 He's gonna die!
Wait!
Stop!
I got
it! Slow dog!
Dude!
Ow!
Suck, man! Okay, if you're a man,
hey, we got a good thing. Don't know if I'ma see you again. But is that a good thing?
girl, I can't be your man. All right, let's get on, man. Let's go.
I got it.
I know what's on your brain. You probably hope it never would end.
Like, is it the real thing? So, that didn't turn out expected.
Yeah, so I guess I can't act like a girl, and
I can't act like a guy.
Yeah, it didn't really work out the way we wanted to.
But these skits show how gender roles relate to different sexes.
Yeah, so for example, when you were walking with heels and doing makeup and
even doing laundry.
Yeah, laundry. I try to mimic that, but it was very unnatural for me to follow her traits.
Because, like Huck, your guys are just like more fidgety.
Yes, and just more aggressive and, you know, stuff like that.
And like when I was playing video games or even lifting weights, like it shows that girls aren't used to violence or aren't as masculine, I guess.
Yeah, so it makes sense.
So this shows what Twain was pointing out, that gender roles relate to how, to what sex you are.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So everybody, thank you for watching the video, and I hope you guys enjoyed it.
And this was our weekly segment.
Stay tuned for next book club.